Hey everybody, we're gonna start on our project today about line, shape, and form. So the materials you're gonna need for this project is a blank sheet of paper. I have some drawing tools as well. Your ruler from your planner is gonna become a really helpful tool if you wanna make nice clean lines. I have a pencil to start. I have a Sharpie for myself, as well as a gray and a black marker. I'm doing my project in black and white. You do not have to. You can choose to do it in color. That's up to you. To start our project, number one, we're gonna begin with a blank sheet of scratch paper from our sketchbook. This one is gonna be one without the holes. Number two, on the loose sheet of paper, you're gonna draw a series of shapes. They should be different in size. Some of them can be the same shape, some of them can be the same size, some of them can be different sizes, whichever you would prefer. So that leads us to step three. Make sure you use your pencil first, because that allows your shapes to overlap, and then you're going to create a composition with your marker in the end. So right now my composition is blank. And what I'm gonna do is kind of think about how I want my eyes to move around the paper. To create an interesting composition, you need to try to pull in the viewer by their eyes, and their eyes need to look all around the paper. You don't wanna focus on just one spot, because then your artwork gets boring for whoever looks at it. So, I'm gonna start with a large square, and let's put it in the corner up here. I'm just gonna kind of eyeball it. These shapes don't have to be perfect. You don't have to use the ruler for all of them. Alright, so I have the start of my square. I'm going to make this one a cube. So I'm going to do diagonal parallel lines. So these lines that I'm making right now are all going the exact same direction. They're the exact same length. And then I connect them. Add a line on the side. There's one. Let's add a circle here. Okay, notice I didn't plant my wrist down. I'm actually using my whole arm, so the only thing touching the paper is my pencil. And that helps me make a nice clean circle. Let's do a big long rectangle here. I have the start of my composition. So far I haven't overlapped anything. The next thing I want to do is start to just continue adding more and more shapes and forms. For example, let's see if I flip this around. I can maybe do a triangle. Maybe I can kind of play with shapes going through each other. So if I want to make this triangle into a 3D triangle, which is a prism, but I don't overlap the line here, and it starts to look like this rectangle is going straight through that pyramid. Okay, what else can I add? let's see, we can do a semisphere over here. If I had a parallel line, follow the curve. We can do a nice big triangle here. Maybe a small circle here. Maybe another small circle here. And that's about as much as I want to go right now. You can add more, you can add less, it's up to you. You're the one making the composition. You want it to be interesting. So me, for example, I want to pull my viewer from one side to the other. And I'm doing that by creating a row of shapes that almost create a line throughout the paper. Once you have your composition and you really, really like it, you're gonna start to go in with your marker and you're gonna outline it. And sometimes where you made lines, you don't have to always add lines where you drew. As an example, maybe I want to leave parts of this triangle uncolored so I can erase it later. Maybe I want to do something like that. And maybe I want to make it look like this pyramid is going into the cube. So maybe I can draw this line, but not draw this. From there, you get something like this. It's the same composition. Now it's just in marker. And now you want to actually start adding some patterns inside of these shapes. However, I'm not going to go in and fill this entire rectangle with the same pattern. The fun part with this, and I'm using my pencil, you can start adding different patterns using different types of line. It's like right now I'm doing just a simple pattern of wavy lines. And maybe inside here, I'm doing some really thick curved lines. And then you can go back in when you're ready and color it. Just going through, picking spots, and putting in new patterns. If you are having trouble thinking of patterns, go into Google, type in line patterns. You have so many things that you can do, it's kind of hard to think of them all. So use your Chromebook and use Google to help. You should have a different pattern in every single shape. Maybe some of these you just want to fill it in, that's okay too. that your lines have different thicknesses as well. So maybe for some parts you want to use a variety of thin and thick lines to give yourself a different pattern. And just keep going. Keep adding different patterns into different shapes. Eventually your page will start to get a little bit crowded, and that's a good thing. You want lots of information because you're gonna end up with something that looks kind of like this. It's all the same shapes. It's the same composition. Except I did add some stuff to fill in these big negative spaces at the very end. But I used a different pattern inside of each and every piece. Some patterns I looked up on Google, some patterns I knew already from old projects. If you have any questions, just let me know. This is going to probably be a little tricky for your brain to make a composition and think of patterns. Sometimes you just need to start drawing and the ideas will come along the way. All right, if you have any questions, raise your hand and let me know.